you, you the.
In this election. I don't have buttons. I can't see it. This and we'll get the final results.
Thank you.
Some of our standing names. We can just shred that one and, let's see, drop it into the shredder. I forgot that one doesn't turn off after.
Very smart.
Well, you know how it's like for, just in general terms, it's an industrial sport versus the one you or I would have at home to do our credit card bills. Jim's. I had like two or three of these pens in front of me, I was like, how did I end up with that?
Sheri made a call.
No, I said I kept them in front of me, so I was like. This is fine. 10.4% from total registered voters.
Excuse me, I'm gonna sneak back by you.
Thank you.
Nine seconds.
Excuse me.
I was being generous, and I'm too.
And I did that without the new name.
Is it still up on my computer? Thank you.
I
Thank you.
Give me a minute, and I can probably... They did not tell me that.
She's like my third cousin or something. Well, she's always been just so beautiful. Is that a problem?
No, enough related. I mean, enough removed.
Yeah, it is.
They're getting the scores. Look at this. He went up 102. We went down 104. And 102. So then, he's going down 104.
Nah.
It's public information.
It's going to be on our state website in a matter of moments.
Okay. So, 25 more days.
If your kids don't kill you before then.
They're going to want to know where we've been.
NAS is official and complete. That one says unofficial and incomplete. This one says official and complete. These say unofficial and incomplete.
Well, yeah, but they're
yeah, I know. One set for you.
Mandy's getting ready for
the form.
The form is ready for us. They actually didn't send me the form, so I'm going to change it.
Courier is theirs, person. Gentlemen in the back house. For Sheri.
Is that what I already have?
Yeah, except for that's read the top.
One of them's unofficial. Is this the newer the official one?
Who gets the last one?
You do.
I have one. You gave me seven.
As you can see, there was only a one vote change in the votes. The official and the unofficial.
Yeah, actually, this one has that one vote right there.
Yeah, because it's the provisional. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The original ones that were started this morning.
Don't have it.
Yeah.
Because the provisional ballot gets added separately. So that changed the overall to
3604.
We actually had a total people that voted of 3604 for a 10.48% of ballots cast. The results show that Ms. Gilligan got 49.96%. Will Kimmer got 4.7. Kramer, I'm sorry, got 4.79. Ethan Underwood got 20.68, and David Van Zandt got 24.75.
So 5.7.
And as for the city council, that is a plurality vote, so therefore the one with the most votes wins, which is Charles Welsh Jr. with 117 votes, as nobody got any close to him. So the board will certify the election, and then it will go from here on to the Secretary of State to certify it.
We do that now.
Does
the chair move to certify the elections as presented by the staff?
The chair so moves.
Second.
No. Motion has been made and seconded that the elections be certified. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All against. The motion is carried unanimously.
By the members present.
By the members present.
And that, you just, I need your signatures.
Right.
Yeah, you'll sign it there as superintendent because you, the meeting, and then you'll sign it, and then I'll send all this to the Secretary of State. Actually, they're going to be picking it up first thing Monday morning, so they should be certifying it down there. But as there has been no change, it has been a minor change to the ballot. That there looks to be a runoff between Ms. Gilligan and Mr. Van Zandt, and that will be held on July 14th, seeing as the state certifies the same thing.
Based on the agenda, there being no further business before this meeting, go ahead and your motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second. There's a motion to adjourn the meeting. Seconded. Any further discussion? Hearing none. All in favor of the motion, say aye.
Aye.
Meeting is adjourned at
4:58. Thank you.
So, just so I'm clear, it's not 48 hours from today, it's 48
hours from
Monday?
From when the Secretary of State.
From when
they certify it, whatever day they
whenever they certify it, it's 48 hours from there.
Oh, that will start the clock, that's what I thought. Have y'all made a final? Is it only going to be for early? Is it going to be one location for the 2 weeks?
The decision has been made that we will not have a Saturday vote because the only Saturday that we're required to have is from the Secretary of State is the Saturday that would be July 3rd, 4th, and because that is the holiday, as it's a runoff, we're not required to have that. The board has met yesterday to
Wednesday.
I'm off the day. And what we will be having is Monday through Thursday of the 29th through the 2nd. We will be here in our office downstairs from 8 to 5.
Okay.
And then the next week we will be open Monday through Thursday at Midway and our office from 8 to 7, and then on Friday we will be open both places from 8 to 5. The reason we don't do Friday till 7 is we have very few voters that came in between the hours of 5 and 7.
So Midway will be open the entire second week?
And because the staff still has to do things after the board, after the election's over, we have to balance everything and download all the cards and get everything ready for our poll workers.
plus change the machines.
Yes, but no, last Friday after this election, we were there until after midnight, so.
Will you send anything to all of the polo people notifying them that the polling location has changed?
We are not sending anything to them. They have gotten, anybody that came to vote got an orange thing. We also have it being posted in Sunday's paper as a rather large ad.
Okay.
Stating for that when our LNA is going to be, our logic and accuracy testing, and also the fact that we are to have changed that only for that location, and it will be, it's not in the legal section, this is an ad in Sunday's paper.
Okay.
And we are looking to also run the same ad without our logic and accuracy part of it on the next Sunday.
And then there'll be signs the day of saying
there will be signs
yeah.
the day of to
sure.
send them located. It's only
okay.
0.6 miles or something. They're both on Majors Road.
Well, we'll help you all spread that message.
Well, that's good. And, and we'll put everything out. It will be on our website, and we get the word out to our voters as best we can.
Absolutely.
If they can't figure it out from that, God help them.
Well, we really do want them to come out and vote, because
yes.
we like everybody in the county to vote.
Absolutely.
So.
We prefer 36,000 people to vote. Well.
Yeah, I know.
That's from your bailiwick.
Yeah.
Actually, you can't have 36,000.
That's true.
If you had 36,000, we'd have a voided election, because we only have 34,000 registered in that district.
Go ahead, Jim. Yes,
the same
yeah,
here.
34,320.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. The wife goes. She's just sitting down over there.
Whitmire with the Forsyth County News.
That was Forsyth County.
That was Forsyth County News?
Yeah.
No, because we don't know. I wanted to talk about what you wanted to say.
Yeah, oh okay, because I misunderstood.
Yeah.
I thought you had it ready.
No, I do. But
right.
We still need to say what?
Absolutely.
See what I mean?
Yeah.
Great. Head off.
So, run off it is.
Good luck.
Thank you.